In this video, you will learn about games which combine 3D models with 2D sprites, how they work, what popular games use this approach, and also a brief instruction on how to set up a project for a game like this in Unity. You will also get to know what are the advantages and disadvantages of using this approach so you can decide for yourself if this is the right way for your game. Interested? Continue watching! Hey, hey, it's Tamara here! To begin with, let's figure out what these games are that combine a 3D world with 2D graphics. You might have heard of the term 2.5D game. Essentially, these games use a 3D world for better movement or animations, but the player can't really see or use the third dimension. In other words, the scene is viewed from a certain point and appears 2D. I've already made a video that featured a 3D world viewed from an isometric perspective, and you can watch it on my channel if you'd like to know more. But what I really want to focus on in this video is using 2D sprites in such 2.5D games, so stay tuned! And just for the clarity, I will be calling it the combined approach, instead of saying each time that it is 2.5D plus 2D sprites. Some people confuse the terms isometric and 2.5D. Isometric is the perspective of viewing the scene when you can see three sides of an object. Even though they were originally made in 2D space, nowadays they can be made in 3D as well. So an isometric game can be in 2.5D. But these terms are not synonyms. 2.5D games can be side view platformers, for instance. In this video, I will be setting up an isometric game which uses a 2.5D approach with a 3D world and models and also flat sprites. You'll see what I mean in a few minutes. There are a few variations of such games, so let's look at some examples. This will help you understand in which cases you should use this combined approach in games. First up is side view platformers. There are a few ways to put together a 3D world and 2D graphics. The simplest one is to put the background on different layers to achieve parallax effect. That's what the developers did in Hollow Knight. I found some footage of behind the scenes where you can see how the game was made. Another way to make a side view platformer is to make the foreground with 3D models and leave the background in 2D. An example of such game is Super Mario. You can see that the background looks quite flat, but the characters have a lot of volume and also animations. There is one more way to make a side scroll with both types of graphics. You can make the background 3D, but the main character is 2D. You can see it in a game called Project Octopath Traveler. It looks interesting, but I'm not sure if there are perks to using this approach in terms of programming. In this particular game, 3D objects have pixelated texture. But you can still see that they are 3D objects, though. Next up is our favorite isometric perspective. The most logical way to use the combined approach is to make the characters 3D models for smooth animations and movement, and the environment with 2D sprites. That's what was done in My Little Pony game from Gameloft. Another way to make an isometric game is to make the environment 3D and characters 2D. This way is used in the game Edgeura from Iska Game Studio. You might have seen these guys on YouTube. They made cubes with buildings textures, kinda like we see in Octopath Traveler, but the main character is a flat figure with rigged 2D animation. I want to mention yet another way to implement 3D with 2D. It is called billboarding. The idea is to make the sprites rotate dynamically, so they will always face the camera. You can see it in one of the Mario games. In this case, characters are flat, they're moving, but the environment is 3D. So, how do you set up a project in Unity? Well, I decided to show you how to make an isometric game, since I think this is one of the hardest. Maybe billboarding is kinda hard too, but I've never done it before, so I can't really show you. I created a 3D project and rotated the camera to 30 degrees on the x-axis and to 45 on the y-axis. The angles actually depend on what type of isometric view you want to achieve. The right isometric with 3 equal angles between all axes, or 2:1 ratio isometric, which is more common in games. Also, make the camera perspective orthographic. Then I created a sprite and assigned an image of an isometrically drawn house. I rotated the sprite to the same angles as I did the camera. And if we look at the camera view, we can see that we have the illusion of a house standing on the ground. Now, let's add a collider to this house so that the characters don't pass through it. This part is a little bit tricky. Create a cube and modify it so the size approximately fits the house. And then just disable its mesh render so all we can see is the collider. You can copy and paste this component on the sprite object directly or just set this invisible cube as a child of the sprite. Now, let's talk about pros and cons of using this combined approach. This will be coming from an experience of a solo game dev, so if you're a big game studio, things might be different for you. And if you're from a big game dev studio, please drop me a comment, cause I'd really like to know, okay? I personally like 2.5D with actual 2D sprites because in this project you can get the best out of both worlds. You can get the 2D perspective that some genres not only favor but basically require, and you also get the advantages of making a 3D game. Let's start with pros so you all get as excited about this combined approach as I am. The first thing is smooth movement of 3D models. You won't be able to achieve the same with sprites unless, of course, you capture frame by frame animations from a 3D model. Well, rigged animation can save you in some cases, but rotations will still be an issue. So if you have a character model, you can find some nice animations on the internet, apply them and just be happy. Next up is details. Getting the detailed look on a 3D model is hard. It is hard for the artist who makes the graphics, it impacts the performance of the game in a bad way. Not necessarily all the time, but sometimes it happens. Whereas making detailed sprites is easier. You will be able to make the graphics faster, and time is of the essence. Even if you don't want to make a very detailed look, 2D still has some charms to it. Some players just like the way it looks. Another important advantage that you can get from using 2.5D is realistic lights and shadows. Even though I know that you can achieve pretty good lighting in a regular 2D game, it is still not the same as in 3D, in my opinion. On the other hand, creating a mixed world can be somewhat challenging. Working with sprites and working with 3D objects is different. For example, you would have to tackle colliders on 2D objects. If this is a side view, then it's no big trouble. But if we take isometric, that's where all the fun begins. Another con, not for the developer but for the player, is a different style. In some cases, the player will notice the difference between models and sprites. It's not too critical, I would rather call it a special, significant detail of the combined approach. Some games manage to blend two worlds almost seamlessly, like Heyday. I'm making a tutorial series about developing a clone of this game, so I spent some time researching it. At first, I didn't even notice that the game had 3D elements in it, until I saw a video about how they were making animated buildings. It's fascinating how many ways there are to combine 2D art with 3D objects. Textures on cube, backgrounds, character sprites, plenty of room for creativity. I want to encourage you to experiment with different views and spaces. Who knows, maybe this particular thing will make your game stand out from the rest. In some cases, using a mixed approach is the best option because of all the possibilities it can bring you. Leave me a comment if you ever noticed how developers mix 3D models with 2D sprites and in which games you've seen it. If you decide to make a game like this, don't forget to share your projects on my Discord server. I'd like to thank all my patrons for supporting me and welcome Charles Barker, Aaron Drury, Moonlight Tide and Franel Baptiste. And that's it for this video! Thank you for watching! Like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more content like this. See you soon! Bye!